this your dog?
Oh, my God. I have to pay you. Thank you so much.
Are you serious?
And how's everything in the dog kidnapping business?
Get a new dog.
Where were you walking him, Charisse?
I always loved Bonnie like he was my own child.
One, I do not want that image in my head. Two, could you go get my dog back?
Hey, what the hell happened?
Some punks jumped us.
Who are you?
Said they were looking for a little shih tzu. Then some other punk killed those punks. It's their blood. It's his puke.
You want to go to the bathroom? Clean some of the blood and the puke off you?
I almost got killed today because you kidnapped the wrong dog.
Are you being serious?
Wow.
What are we going to do?
We could take on all the bad guys, maybe in the desert.
And what do you think we should do in real life?
How you doing?
What's your name?
Shut up. We'll get you back to your daddy in a day or two. Don't be sad.
Pa. Pa. No, Pa. That's okay, too.
I gotta pull myself together, I know. But my dog's gonna end up killed.
You're not pulling yourself together, are you?
Peter, you've gotta give it back.
Give it back? I'm gonna just give back a kidnapped dog. Defeats the entire object of the kidnapping.
Put your hands up.
No.
But I've got a gun.
I don't care.
That doesn't make any sense.
Too bad.
I'm going to work.
Are you pissed at me for something, baby?
Why would I be pissed at you, Marty?
Because you're a killie.
You waiting for somebody, old guy?
No.
Okay, you seem normal. Come on in. We got to get this dog off the street because it's kidnapped from a maniac.
Dandy.
I like it. It's got layers.
Yeah.
An eye for an eye leaves the whole world blind.
No, it doesn't. There'll be one guy left with one eye. How's the last blind guy gonna take out the eye of the last guy left?
Now this is the kind of movie Colin Farrell should be making, and it's the kind of movie his fans want to see him make, people he won over with in Bruges, which is the last film he made with this writer-director, Martin McDonagh, and it's actually the last film Martin McDonagh made. This is his follow-up several years later. It looks great, but it's interesting. At the same time, it surprised me. It caught me a little off guard because it reminds me of a kind of film they used to make in the 1990s, which is, I would say, L.A. Noir, where it would kind of focus on the fringes of Hollywood society, the people who kind of had one foot in and another foot in like the wasteland of, you know, dreams not coming true. Like what happens in Hollywood between, you know, the tremendous downtime that certain people have in the industry. And in this film, Colin Farrell, even though their two people are criminals, dog nappers, Colin Farrell plays a screenwriter. So those kind of films, like The Player, 2 Days in the Valley, True Romance, were quite good. And they really got a serious cult following and they launched a couple careers. For instance, Quentin Tarantino wrote True Romance. It was one of his first scripts. So that was good, but at the same time, those films never really grossed at the box office, and they didn't do particularly well at awards season either. So I question why bring that genre back, because I don't think that the demographic for it has expanded since the 1990s. That said, the people who love those films, like me, I'm excited to see that kind of film come back. And, you know, people always quote these films, and it has kind of, like, those films have kind of like a following that even Swingers, I would say, might go in that category to some degree. You don't really see that kind of film anymore. The one that people quote from and really has a lasting impression on it, it's called Audience. So this looks cool to me. I like seeing Colin Farrell doing what Colin Farrell does best, and for some reason doesn't do most of the time. Of course, I think Sam Rockwell and Christopher Walken are a great pair. It's nice to see Christopher Walken. I loved his line at the end of the trailer with not willing to put his hands up. It's nice to see Christopher Walken in a vehicle that is slightly above where he set the bar for himself these days. Nice to see him returning to maybe a little more quality entertainment. And I like seeing Woody Harrelson in this type of role. I think it's a nice stretch. It's not too far for him because it's still comedy, but I think it'll be interesting to see him in that role. And who doesn't like to look at a bunch of cute dogs either? So I think Martin McDonagh is going to really do well at the core demographic that he, you know, this kind of film appeals to, but I really don't think it's going to do particularly well at the box office or award season. Hopefully I'm surprised. You know, maybe the Golden Globes, because they liked In Bruges so much. What do you think? Do you think there's hope for Seven Psychopaths to expand beyond its target demographic? And if you are that target demographic, is this the kind of film you want to see? Be sure to write your thoughts down below, and thank you so much for coming to Beyond the Trailer, not just to check out the latest trailers, but to get snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching.